Welcome to week 8 of The Rundown. Glad to have you with us as always. I'm Ron Burke.
And I'm Bethany Miller. While many of you are enjoying this year's Balloon Fiesta, we have major matchups across the high school football landscape.
Great night. We begin at Community Stadium for a 6A top 10 matchup between Siebel and Volcano Vista, two highly potent offenses with great quarterbacks. Siebel is 6-0, averaging 42 points. Volcano at 5-2, scoring 35 a game. And the Hawks in the end zone courtesy of Elijah Gonzalez from short yardage. Volcano Vista up 7. And they get the ball again. And this time, quarterback Elliott Paskett-Bell, he's answering the bell. Look at him, hard to take down. And they're again knocking on the door. And Paskett-Bell's going to make it pay off when he finishes off the drive with a quarterback sneak. It's 14-0. Then at 14-7, Paskett-Bell has the ball in his hands again, rolling, finding Devin Banks with a defensive back clinging to him. It's another touchdown, 21-7. Now, the Cougars need points. Their standout QB, Aiden Chavez, under pressure here. Watch him get taken down by the defense. Maybe a critical play because of what happens on the next play when Chavez, working in the pocket, completes a pass. But we look back in the pocket, and Chavez is on the ground grabbing his lower left leg. They come out and tend to him, medical personnel putting his leg in a splint. And as you can see, they take him off in a wheelchair. Tough setback for the senior quarterback. We wish him all the best. A difficult night all around for Siebel, as it turns out, because Paskett-Bell and the Hawks would light up the night and the school board. We zero in on the ball here because it finds Tristan Cordova for the touchdown to make it 28-7, and Volcano Vista piles up the points, beating Siebel 57-7.
Well, Ron, over to Wilson Stadium we go. The Matadors of Sandia taking on the El Dorado Eagles in a big district matchup here tonight. Tied 7-7 nearing the end of the second quarter. 4th-and-3. Eagles quarterback Brandon Olivas finds Josiah Mitchell in the end zone for 6. El Dorado PAT is good. So Eagles up 14-7. Sandia would have plenty of time before heading to the locker room. Cruz Rivera hits Malachi Times on the run. A 61-yard catch-and-run touchdown for the Matadors. That knocks this game up at 14s just right before the break. Obviously a lot of momentum. So to start off the third quarter, Sandia driving, Rivera hands it off to Times, but the ball is popped loose. El Dorado comes up with a huge fumble recovery. Matthew Burke with the huge play for the Eagles. El Dorado would capitalize too. 2nd and goal, you've seen this play before. Olivas to Mitchell for 6, and El Dorado takes the lead against Sandia. PAT no good, so it's 20-14, but Ron, this game goes to double overtime.
Wow.
How about those Eagles? 42-39 is the final.
Oh, a lot of high scoring there.
Matadors.
Newcomers in Class 6A, the Los Lunas Tigers at 3-4, taking on Albuquerque High. Just 1-5 on the season. Tigers, they're roaring and ready to go. Well, they get going on the ground when Nicholas Torres throws it on spin cycle. Watch the move. Gets a big gain that leads to a field goal, so it's 3-0 Los Lunas. But the Bulldogs, right back, running back Abron Behill gets loose, and they finally take him down. Thought he might break it. Does not lead to points, though. Albuquerque's defense coming up big. Jesus Vitica engulfs the quarterback, Paul Searmans, here. And on the next play, here they come again. Pass rush dropping Searmans again. But Searmans stays tough, says, I've had enough. The keeper on 4th down, he fights for the yardage. They move the chains. And later, Searmans from inside his own 10, he'll roll. He'll launch this way inside his own 10 now.
Wow.
Launches way downfield. That's Fabian Trujillo at the receiving end, stunning the defense with a 91-yard touchdown connection just before the half. Los Lunas turns a 10-0 halftime lead into a 27-zip shutout of Albuquerque High.
What a play there. Let's switch fields all the way to Las Cruces. We go to Field of Dreams, where in Las Cruces, the Bulldogs looking to get a big win over Alamogordo. Ron, these two teams have a long-standing history. This one would be fun. Bulldogs with the ball here. Quarterback Matt Lashley back to pass. He finds Jacob Mays just right over the top. Mays on the move with some room to run. Bounces off the Tigers tacklers before he's brought down by what seems like the literal entire field there. So Las Cruces is still on the hunt. Lashley hands it off to David Barella. He's looking to run, but the ball popped right into the hands of Rusty Davidson. He says, I'll take that. Davidson pumps it downfield before he's brought down right inside the 20. A little winded after the fact, though. That wouldn't matter. Tigers finish this drive. Elijah Montoya with the keeper into the end zone. Alamogordo on the board. The Tigers, they win off a game-winning interception at the goal line. 13-10 is your final. It is the first time, Ron, Alamogordo has beaten Las Cruces since the mid-2000s. All right, finally over to Milanese Stadium we go. Pahokee Valley facing the Hornets of Highland. Check out that moon there as Highland is ready to go. Hornets ball in the first quarter. What a trick play this is, even as the cameraman fooled there for a bit. But we finally find Timbani Mwanza on the move for a 20-yard gain and a Highland first down. Then it'd be fourth and goal for the Hornets. Isaiah Herrera, the handoff to Alex Lopez, who runs it right up the gut for pay dirt. Highland on the board, 6-0 over the Elks as the bell rings on. PAT attempt would turn into a trick play. Lopez over the top to Mwanza, making all the plays on this drive just like that. It's 8-0 over the Elks. That's still the score in the second. Lopez under center this time with the keeper. Breaks a couple of tackles here, refusing to go down until he's way past midfield. The Hornets would attempt a 45-yard field goal after that to go up 11-0 over the Elks. Unfortunately, just a bit short. No sweat, though. Hornets would light up the scoreboard on fire. Highland over Pahokee Valley, 56-7. Well, Ron, from the high school gridiron to University Stadium. Next on the rundown, head coach Danny Gonzalez tells us how they're wanting to bounce back after a tough loss against UNLV. Gonzalez and the Lobo football team will aim for their first conference win in three tries this season when they take on Wyoming at home tomorrow.
Lobos coming off those back-to-back losses. They let one slip away last weekend when they lost a 17-0 lead and the game at UNLV. Now, so far, they're 0-2 in a 12-team Mountain West conference that Gonzalez said this week is probably as closely matched as it's been in a long time.
It's a big opportunity for us to continue to grow in this program and have a chance to compete at with the upper echelon of this league. The next seven are exactly that. This league is as closely matched competitively from top to bottom as it's probably been in a long time. We don't have a team that is so much better than everybody else. There's probably a couple on the very, very bottom that are struggling, but that doesn't mean they can't beat any of the teams that they play over the next 7 weeks.
Last October, Isaiah Chavez was the starting quarterback when the Lobos went to Wyoming and beat the Cowboys 14-3. A lot has changed since then. Kickoff tomorrow is at 5 o'clock. And thanks in part to one of the best hustle plays we've seen this season.
Well, Heather Dyche and the UNM women's soccer team got their four-game homestand, off to a winning start. The play that got the Lobos on the scoreboard first is this breakaway by Leilani Baker. After receiving a pass, she's off and running the other way. The redshirt senior from Rio Rancho High School missed last season with a torn ACL. And check that out. She outruns everyone to score the first of her two goals last night in the Lobos 3-1 win. Just this week, the head coach said the players put a lot on their shoulders to be great.
Because they've had so much success, they feel a lot of pressure to recreate that. So I think what we're trying to do right now is just stay present and enjoy playing and commit to doing the right things. And I think if they do that, they'll find the success that they're hoping for.
Well, next up for the Lobos, game two of that four-game homestand Sunday against San Jose State. Well, on the hardwood, we're now exactly 1 month away from the Lady Lobos tipping off their upcoming season. After tying the most wins they had in a single season last year, looking to get back to the top. Mount West Media Days is Wednesday, October 12th. The men's is on Thursday, the 13th.
The New Mexico United game against LA Galaxy 2 has been rescheduled after steady rain wreaked havoc Wednesday, making the field unplayable. The two teams will meet next Wednesday, the 12th at Isotopes Park, in a 7 o'clock start. That game will start from the beginning, and it means United will play Sunday, Wednesday, and Saturday next week to close out the regular season and try to hold on to that playoff spot. So we're looking forward to that. Up next, we'll preview more of the high school football action happening this weekend. High school football action happening Saturday. You can catch some action after going to Balloon Fiesta and make it a full day for yourself. Dexter will take on Hope Christian, Manzano will take on Valley, and Rio Rancho will meet Atrisco Heritage. All those matchups should be exciting.
Yeah, Ron, especially Balloon Fiesta if you saw it down there. All right, in case you missed any of our show, head to our website, KOAT.com. We'll have a full recap of it with all the highlights.
As always, thanks for watching the rundown. Back next Friday with week 9 of high school football action and more.
And have a fun week for the rest of Balloon Fiesta. Good night.